Shata. Share the live broadcast, invite somebody. Welcome everybody. Welcome somebody tonight for this wonderful moment. Welcome everybody live. Let the Lord Jesus do something tonight. Something amazing is about to take place. Shara Baba Babu Seya, that's the Zoom link. Beyond that, just let's flow with the Spirit. Let God do something. Welcome somebody tonight. Sala Baba Baba Seya Razia. Mama Mama Antele de Shele Bregadoa Sa. Sala Baba Baba Shiteria. Sekatata La Bregata. Father, we thank you for this wonderful time. We thank you for this wonderful visitation tonight. In Jesus' mighty name, touch us, God. Visit us. Take us to a deeper dimension. You are amazing, God. There is no one like you. Welcome somebody tonight. I see Facebook Live, I see on Zoom. We got a couple of people. Let the Lord bless you all. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Alima, good morning to you. Shaladadaba Santana Baba Babu Siada. Zeteteba Zeto Sheprekata. Let's, we serve a living God today. Welcome somebody. Talk to someone. Let something good happen today. Welcome somebody tonight, this morning, this hour, this moment. Distance is not a barrier. Thank you, Lord. Se baba 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 sheta la da baba baba siya. Senta la braha. Shalom to you, King. Karia da zote le hara da ziya. Nele baba baba sheta de boa. Pola braga. This is day 6 of the 90 days of prayer and fasting. This is day 6. We end on December the 13th. No, August the 13th. August the 13th. August the 13th is when we end. August the 13th. Shireen, you say good morning. Good morning to you. God bless you. Friend, you're my everything. I trust you, no one else but you. Arabasin tele baba babo shelea, tele brahata la brahata skitela, son tele da 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 shela. Thank you, Lord. Arababa baba son tele briga. This is day 6. Share the live broadcast. Invite somebody tonight, this morning, from wherever you're watching me from. Let God do something amazing. Allah baba baba baba. Let's get in this atmosphere. Let's create an atmosphere tonight. This morning, from wherever you're watching me, create an atmosphere around your room. Talk to God. Nala da seka telebreha. Audrey, you say morning prophet. God bless you. Talala da da shika telebreha. Create an atmosphere right now. Let the Lord Jesus do something this morning, this afternoon. Distance is not a barrier. Let's pray. Let's pray. Zebra, bless your children, Lord. Touch them tonight. Let them experience a love that's beyond human understanding. Karabasetelebreha. Zentolahala dasheha. Zentelebregato se brigato lebreha. Zekata la breha to shebregato. Talk to God. Open up your mouth and pray with me. Say, Lord Jesus.
Jesus,
sanctify me this hour.
Sanctify me.
You can unmute your Zoom. You can unmute it and pray with me. I'm looking at people on social media here, live and also on Zoom. Unmute your voice and pray if you can pray. If you have a voice, you can pray. Praise God. Say, Lord Jesus.
Lord Jesus.
Touch my life.
Touch my life.
Transform me.
Transform me.
Do something new.
Do something new.
Resurrect.
Resurrect.
Everything.
Everything.
The enemy has terminated.
The enemy has terminated.
Out of my life.
Out of my life.
Lord Jesus.
Lord Jesus.
Sanctify me.
Sanctify me.
Give me wisdom.
Give me wisdom.
Give me grace.
Give me grace.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Jesus.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Jesus' mighty.
As I pray.
As I pray.
Unmute your volume if you can pray. Raise up your voice loud as the Lord leads you. Karabadis katalabra. Begin talking to God. Say, Lord, I can do better than this. Lord, give me grace today. Just like God gave Samson one more time grace, God is going to give you grace one more time. The same way he gave Samson grace one more time. He destroyed more Philistines than ever. So talk to the Lord this morning, this hour, in Jesus' mighty name. Kala bata sete la bakato shepre kato sea. Lepata shapraka. Talk to God. Talk to God. Tell him this is my season.
This is my season.
Nothing was going to stop me.
Nothing's gonna stop me.
No man is going to stop me.
No man is gonna stop me.
No affliction is going to stop me.
No affliction is going to
stop me. No confusion is going to stop me.
No confusion is
going to stop me. In Jesus' mighty name.
Jesus' mighty name.
I am sanctified.
I am sanctified.
I am prepared for war.
I'm prepared for war.
I am fashioned for war.
I'm fashioned for war.
This moment.
This moment.
This night.
This night.
I'm sanctified.
I'm sanctified.
By the blood of Jesus. I am fashioned for war.
I'm fashioned for
day
war.
Six.
Day six.
The number of men.
The number of
I will
men.
Have favor with men.
I will have favor with
this
men.
This is day six.
Yes, Lord.
Day six.
Yes, Jesus.
You know, it's the sixth day that God created man.
Yes.
Six is a prophetic number. There's a reason why he created him on the sixth. And you know, when you see the devil himself, he likes mocking God. That's why he does 666. When you hear 666, it's a mockery to God's creation. We are the image of God. That's a mockery to God's creation. That's what you find in Revelation 13. He talks about 666. That's what it signifies. It's like the number of the beast is 666. I'm double the man you created. As a mockery. That's why on the sixth day, God created man. So there are things that fight humanity. There's a lot of things in this world that humanity faces. You know? Karadabazetelebregata. May you not be under affliction. In Jesus' mighty name. May you not be under affliction. In Jesus' mighty name. Shefrekata sabrekantolede. Let's pray. Marabado celebrega. Talk to God. Talk to God this hour, this moment. Tell him I need your grace. I see Alima here, she's on fire. Vanessa. I see Vanessa on fire. I see William on Zoom. I see Bonnie. I see Frida. I see Zola. I see Mariah. I see Sheila. We are dealing with strongholds tonight. Strongholds that hold a man behind. Nothing is too impossible for God. If you're watching me online on Facebook Live, share it to 12 prophetic people coming to your spirit. Let God be elevated in your life. This hour, this moment, talk to God. Leta la da bababo shele bababa. Zinta la bababo shele la bababo siya. Nenkara bababo seria baka. So tele baba babo shele bababa. Talk to God. La bragada zebregada za. Sele baba babo shele de gada da da. Zita tata prakata sala krakatoa. This friend, you're my everything. I trust. By the virtue of you being here, your life will be transformed. In Jesus' mighty name, by the virtue of you being here, something is transpiring in your life. Something is transpiring in your life. The number six is the number of men. May you find favor with men tonight. If you have not had favor with men for the longest, may you find favor. The Bible says Jesus grew in wisdom, stature, favor with God, and favor with men. Sometimes we have favor with God because we pray. There are things you can tell God, but there are things you cannot tell a man. When you go and you try telling a man, it's a problem. You get rejected with demonic affliction. Favor with men is very important. So number six, this is day six. May six favor you. Hallelujah. May number six not fight you. May your number as a man, Karaba, created in the image of God. Zompala bashute prekatosia. You are blessed today in Jesus' mighty name. Kalabahara da zikata lahara dosia. Letoshia. Nekata labraha. Dishikata labreha. Sikata labraha. Dishikata ladazea. Tore de bakatosia. Do something new in your life. In your life. Tell the Lord. Do something new in my life tonight. This morning, do something new. This hour, do something new in my life. Talk to God. Talk to God. Do something new. Renew my mind. Talk to God. Lekata la bregadusia. Litata pashete krekata. Lebaha. Sikata tabaria. Zikato le bregadusia la. Dajua. Pray in the spirit if you can. Oh God, transform and touch my life. Renew my mind to another dimension. Talk to God. Say, God, transform me, touch my life. You renew my life to another dimension. Talk to God. Renew my life to another dimension. Talk to God. Talk to God right now. Setala bregadusia la dabo, shia dadababusia. If you are on Zoom and I need to hear you pray, raise up your voice, unmute your button. If you can pray, pray. I need to hear you pray. Unmute your button and pray. Talk to God. If my people shall humble themselves and pray. It doesn't say and seek prophecy. It says and pray. It doesn't say and look for miracles. It says and pray. It doesn't say look for healing. It says pray. Pray. Jesus said, my Father's house shall be the house of what? Prayer. There's something about prayer. Prayer is meditation. The highest form of prayer is meditation. When you're able to be still in the presence of God, but at the same time know when to declare life. So right now what we're doing, we're in the realm of declaration. In prayer, there is different realms. There is different types of prayer. There is prayers of declaration where you're speaking into the atmosphere. You're prophesying over yourself. That's also prayer. You're prophesying into the atmosphere. You're speaking into what you cannot see physically, but you're speaking by faith. That's prayer. Prayer, declaration. And after declaration is prayers of meditation, where you get to a place where you meditate within yourself. You're talking to God. Now, prayers of meditation is premeditating what God has done in your life and just thinking about what God has already done and what He's going to do. And you meditate on that. Is there any good thing? Is there any good news? The Bible says meditate on it. Praise God. So that is meditation there. Divine meditation. Meditation. Then there is intimacy. Now we know intimacy, meditation. Parabazika talabria. Prayers of intimacy is between you and God. How much you love God. You know, declaring His goodness in your life. His mercy in your life. So talk to God this morning. Talk to God this evening. Tell Him how much He's amazing in your life. Talk to Him. Deliverance. Prayers of deliverance. These are prayers that break chains. Things that are impossible are broken. You know, things that have held you captive for so long. Limitation, confusion, oppression. This is the realm of prayer of deliverance. This is the prayers of deliverance. It goes in the prayers of deliverance. Labati shipreka. Ah, siprikata seprikata. What's going on? Can you check my feed? My live feed.
Pala brigata. They cannot hear.
Huh?
They say they
cannot hear. Can you guys go on live, my live feed.
Okay.
Can you hear me? Good. Okay. What's going on? It's okay.
I think maybe on Zoom.
It's okay. Yeah. Can you guys hear me on Zoom? Can you hear me on Zoom? Can you guys, is somebody unmute your volume? It's okay.
I'm going to continue.
I don't know what that is, but let's continue praying. This is day 6. It is well with the righteous. This is day 6. Let's pray. It's okay. I don't know what it is, but let's keep praying. Let's keep praying. Know that by it is well. Let's keep praying. Keep sharing right now on Facebook Live. I'm here. Join me and share to 12 prophetic people that are coming to your spirit. Kala babadus ketela dos ketela blaha tush ketela braha zitalada zukuta la brigadush ketela brea nentili brigadi ziadada. A blessing is already overshadowing, overwhelming the household of Alima. The blessing is overshadowing and overwhelming the household of Alima already. Is overwhelming and overshadowing the household of Alima already. Zibatush ketela breha. Sikato shepreka seprekata. In Jesus' mighty name, the household of Alima is being overwhelmed. You say, yes, we can hear you. Now, this is much better. You know, one thing is this, we continue no matter what. We move on no matter what. Nemakato sketelebreha. Zitash ketelebreha. Zotelebreha. Lupushuti prekata sketelea. Undalabrega dosia. Teshika. Thank you, God, for doing what you have to do in the lives of your children. Nemanto lebrege, she says, yes, we can hear you. Mahala dashiti krikata. Pray these prayers of declarations with me this hour, this moment, in Jesus' mighty name. Kala duskete lebreha. Nanto lebrega duskete lebreha. Kala braha. Sititi brikatuskete lebreha. Nemanto lebreha. Can you hear me? It's a little bit too. Shelebreka saprekatua. Let's pray. Open up your mouth. Kaladishi siprekata. Shelebreka to siprekatua. Balade shelebrekata. Sitata labrekatuskia. I can hear you live, but Zoom is logging in. Is logging. There's a problem of lagging with Zoom. I'm going to work with social media, Facebook Live. We're going to pray. This is what we're going to do online. So join me on day 6 and let's pray. So, dear Heavenly Father, is it what's happening? Kala Baha. Kala Brahatush Kitelebre. Kala Dadishitelebreha. We thank you, God, for this wonderful time. La tata ta prekata sea. Zo prekata shete prekata. Lord, arise and fight the battle of your children today. Pray after me. Say,
Lord Jesus Christ,
every territorial spirit
in the air,
spirits on the earth,
invisible spirits
to my natural eyes,
shadow magic.
I command it to break.
In
Jesus' mighty name.
This moment.
Shadow magic.
Witchcraft.
Juju.
Pray.
Out of my life.
Shadow magic.
Witchcraft.
Voodoo.
Juju.
Break.
Out of my life.
Out of my destiny.
I am set free.
I am set free.
By the blood of Jesus.
Any man.
Any woman.
Who's assigned.
Against my destiny.
In the spirit world.
In the name of Jesus.
They are arrested today.
Today they are arrested.
I declare and decree.
A curfew.
In the spiritual realm.
Over every gathering.
Of witches.
Sorcerers.
Voodoo priests.
Black magic.
Black magic.
Blue magic.
Red magic.
I command it to break.
This moment.
Jesus' mighty name.
Any curse.
That has been placed over my life.
Curse of limitation.
I command it to break.
If you're joining me online,
pray with me online.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus.
Curse of limitation.
Curse of confusion.
Break out of my life.
In Jesus' mighty name.
I declare and decree.
Every household.
Spirit of death.
Tormenting my bloodline. Untimely death.
Untimely accident.
I break free from this accident.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Open up your mouth and pray. You can unmute yourself and begin to pray. We need to hear you. I need to hear you. Or unmute yourself and pray. Don't come and just watch without praying. You have to engage in prayer. This is corporate prayer. The most important ministry than any ministry, than teaching, than anything is prayer. Because it is prayer that makes us have revelation. And we find out what God has done.
Hallelujah.
So open up your mouth and pray.
Yes, Lord.
Whatever is happening to the network, praise God. Let us pray.
Hallelujah.
We overcome every evil child. We overcome every evil affliction. In Jesus' mighty name. Talk to God right now. Talk to God right now. I overcome demonic affliction.
Yes, Lord.
This hour.
This moment.
Tonight. Me and my household.
We are set free.
We are delivered.
In Jesus' mighty name.
By the fire of God.
We are sanctified.
We are set free.
I'm a battle axe.
In the hand of the Lord.
I am a battle axe.
In the hand of the Lord.
In the hand of the Lord.
Every demonic enchantment.
Resisting this move.
Let it break tonight.
It is broken tonight.
Gathering of witches.
Catch fire.
Gathering of sorcerers.
Catch fire.
Gathering of wizards.
Catch fire.
In Jesus' name.
Gathering of wizards.
Sorcerers. Catch fire.
Tonight.
Every evil hand. Catch fire. I speak judgment.
Over any spirit.
Of manipulation.
At this hour.
I command this evil spirit. To break tonight.
Out of your life.
Your destiny
shall be delivered.
Put your hands on your head and say, Lord.
Lord.
My destiny is being delivered. Nothing will stop.
The network.
Nothing will stop.
My provision. Tonight.
By fire. I am not distracted.
I'm ready.
To be delivered.
This hour.
This moment.
Demonic affliction.
Has lost influence.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Some of you are under monitoring spirits.
Yes, Lord.
Every time you try to do something, it keeps backfiring.
Oh,
some of you are under monitoring spirits.
Yes, Lord.
Anytime you try to do something, it backfires. You know, this my Zoom is being controlled at this hour. No one is touching my Zoom. But whatever is in control or whoever in the spiritual realm, we command whatsoever they are doing to backfire.
Yes.
Let every person who sent an assignment that is not of God run under the spirit of insanity this hour.
Yes, Lord.
Let
yes.
them run mad
yes.
in Jesus' mighty name.
I
declare and
decree.
You know, things like this begin to happen when people of God are about to be delivered.
Yes.
That's why whenever I pray, I have the highest form of network, internet, the highest you could ever find.
Yes.
My internet is the highest. My network is the highest. But the reason why this is happening, look, it's controlling itself. No one is touching it. The reason why my Zoom is controlling itself like this is because of forces of darkness.
Yes.
Believe me as I say,
yes.
When children of God gather in the spirit world,
come
there is
now.
Fire.
Yes.
Let me tell you. Do you know there are people here in Los Angeles tonight who cannot sleep? They're like, this man needs to stop. They're about to do a 90-day prayer and fasting. And from Los Angeles to whatever country you are in Europe, in Africa, deliverance is taking place. Look. It's not about the magnitude of people. It's about the magnitude of the faith of
yes.
those who are there. And that's why this is happening now. And that's why I'm not stopping. Whenever you pray, things happen. Look at the internet. We have the highest internet, the highest GB. Zikata la bregata. But the reason why whatever is happening or whoever is controlling this is because of the fire of God. Witchcraft.
Let it break.
Witchcraft.
Scatter.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Say,
My destiny
shall not be interfered.
By the second heaven.
By the second heaven.
My destiny
shall not be controlled. By spirits in the air. Do you know there are spirits that live in the second heaven, the air? That's why in Ephesians 6:10 it says, we don't wrestle against flesh and blood, but principalities in high places. High places. But let me tell you something. There is power in the blood of Jesus. You know, Paul said, I wanted to come to you, but Satan resisted me over and over and over and over again. Paul was resisted to go deliver the message. He couldn't deliver because he was resisted. Some of you are facing demonic resistance. I'm here to tell you, as you're watching me from whatever country you're watching me from, unmute your Zoom, unmute your voice, begin to pray now. Say, Lord, this is day six.
Yes.
The number of men. Talk to God. This is day six. Say, this is day six.
This
talk to
day
God.
Six.
The number of men.
The
devil mocked God in the book of Revelation, Apocalypse, by saying 666 according to Revelation 13. It was a mockery to God's creation, to humanity, to say, I'm triple the man you've created. You've created this one to replace me. I'm triple. Because he used to live in heaven. But there's a God who's in heaven. And after these 90 days, something will break in your life. I declare and decree,
every mermaid spirit,
any mermaid spirit,
yes, Lord,
controlling the spirit world, In the name of Jesus, controlling with frustration, evil arrows of confusion, of pain, of affliction, begin to break now. In Jesus' mighty name, I say fire of the Holy Ghost. Holy Ghost fire. Holy Ghost fire. Holy Ghost fire. Holy Ghost fire. Through the blood of Jesus, I am set free. I am delivered. Holy Ghost fire. Holy Ghost fire.
Oh God,
arise
and consume
what is delaying my life. What has afflicted my life. Every evil invisible hand holding me back in the spirit world. Holding me back in the prison. Prison of the second heaven. I break free from satanic prisons and chains and afflictions that have bound my hand and feet. Child of God, you can do better than this.
Every affliction
binding my legs,
binding my hands,
through the blood of Jesus, I am set free.
My legs and hands,
my head,
my
chairs,
my health,
my family,
my spouse,
my friends,
anybody
in my family,
in my household,
working charm
against my life.
I command the charm to break
by the fire of God.
The charm is broken
by the fire of God.
The witchcraft is broken
by the fire of God.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Demonic affliction.
Demonic food in the dream.
I flush it out.
Some of you keep dreaming like you're eating.
It is not of God for you to keep eating in the dream.
I repeat again. If they have access to you in the dream, then they can control your physical. Before the spiritual, watch this. Before the physical manifests, the spiritual is there. If they can control the spirit, they can control the physical. That's why some of you have dreamt like a dog is biting or you're being scratched and you wake up, you're having a scratch, you're having bruises. And you're like, I literally dreamt like someone was about to shoot me. And when you wake up, your heart is beating. Because in the spirit world, it was happening. There is demonic assassination that takes place in the spirit world. You can see a woman walking. You know, she's walking normal, well, you know, and it looks like nothing is wrong. But in the spirit world, she died long time ago. She died long time ago. They kill you in the spirit before they kill you in the physical. Death is not physical first. It's spiritual before physical. So any death, any coffin prepared for you in the spirit, I declare and decree. Any coffin, whatever coffin they prepared for you, I declare and decree they will fall in that pit. In Jesus' mighty name, repeat, open up your mouth, pray loud and clear. You can do better than this. Say, every coffin prepared with my name on it.
Prepared with my name on it.
Let this coffin catch fire.
Let this coffin catch fire.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Jesus' mighty name.
Let this coffin catch fire.
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 Let every evil handwriting.
Every evil handwriting.
Written against my destiny.
Written against my destiny.
Catch fire tonight.
Catch fire tonight.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Jesus' mighty name.
Children of God, let me tell you. I traveled to recently in 2021. I traveled to the nation of Kenya. When I arrived there, I was in Nairobi. I was talking to a woman. She was a house help. And I spoke to her. And I said, hey, why am I seeing the spirit of death over your life? I'm troubled by you. You need deliverance, mama. Why am I seeing death? She said, my husband just died last year. I said, ah, really? What happened? She began explaining it was a motorcycle accident. And she survived. I said, that was not for your husband. That was you. I told her, get in a fast. Lock yourself at least 1 week. Prayer and fast. Mama, you need to fast. Because you see, God is a God of love. Whether you're a house help, it doesn't matter your level or your status. If God loves you, he will warn you. So I gave a prophetic word. My brother was able to hear. And I said, ma'am, you need to pray because I'm looking at you. I don't see you in the land of the living.
This is not the will of God for you to your time to be terminated and for you to leave this earth before your time. So mama, go and pray. She said, okay, okay, okay. She was crying. The woman didn't go and pray. She was so afflicted, too much stress with the family in the village, too much people in the countryside calling her, asking her for a lot. She got worried with the issues of life. She didn't fast. I received the phone call and I was told the woman died because she was eternally bleeding. Her brain, she had a stroke. From nowhere, she couldn't wake up. She was solid, like ice. When they woke up, they found her solid like ice. I told her, the will of God is for you not to die. But as I look at you in a vision, I'm not seeing you in the land of the living. God wants you to live because there's a purpose he wants you to fulfill. There are people right now who are in the grave. The grave is a place that's very rich. It's rich because of destinies that were never fulfilled. Do you know that? People who died at the age of 20. Someone who dies at the age of 19, 18, 16 with a promising career. Very gifted. All of a sudden, they slept. They didn't wake up. All of a sudden, they crossed the road and they got crushed. Another incident was a man. This man came here in Los Angeles. A Nigerian man, very, you know, slick businessman, a tycoon, multimillionaire. He's crossing the road in a place, Santa Monica. It's like the road to the close to the beach. While he was crossing, he didn't see. When he turned left like this, a big truck came, crushed him so bad. The only thing that made them recognize it was him. It was his head. He was decapitated. A multi-millionaire who had a wife, who had a kid, had just visited from Nigeria here to Los Angeles. Here in Los Angeles, he was separated from his head to show you that, his head was in perfect condition while his body was separated to show you that was a ritual. He died. He left the land of the living without fulfilling his destiny. Young guy, strong. He's crossing the road. What makes him not? He had cars, Lamborghini, Maserati, all the cars you could ever imagine. You could ever find Rolls Royce, millionaire. Yeah, a millionaire gone to the grave without fulfilling a lot of things he was to fulfill. This we call untimely death. Hey, if you're with me yesterday night, you heard the things I said. I ministered to a lady and I was able to get in touch with her. She was able to get in touch with me concerning her father and inheritance and her being in a hotel. It was exactly what had happened. Before her mother died, her mother, she explained to me, had left an inheritance of $500,000. But when the stepdad found out, as soon as she left, she came back, the mother was no more, you know, rushed, whatever, gone. So everything in the title deed was switched to the name of the stepfather. She was kicked out, nothing. And the mother, before she died, she said, my daughter, everything I possess is yours. Listen, there are people who suffer misfortune, not because it's just misfortune. Spirits are real. There are people who walk with spirits. They walk with spirits. And you as a believer, you also need to walk with the Spirit of God. It's either you're walking with the Spirit of God or you're being influenced by evil spirits. So this lady is no more. 2021, she's gone. January, terminated. So now, is it a good news? No, because she's not supposed to be 6 feet under, buried in the village. Listen, any demonic spirit, any person in your life who has been sent to bury your destiny. Oh, you didn't hear this. Some of you have been in relationships. Some of you have been in marriages in the past. Some of you have been in friendship that was not friendship. It was nothing but affliction. You are friends with a wizard. You don't even know it. They just look at you, they smile, they laugh, but in their bloodline is wizardry. Every time they speak things, it comes to pass, but it's always negative. That's a sign of a wizard. And they're very braggadocious. They say, whenever I speak, things happen. That's a wizard. That's a sorcerer. You see, there's a born wizard and there's a wizard who becomes a wizard. There's a born witch and there's a witch who starts practicing witchcraft. Those are two different things. A born witch and a born wizard, it is somebody where it runs in the bloodline. It's like an inheritance they inherit in the spirit, traditionally. So they are able to control things that are beyond our control physically. So, I want you to open up your mouth. This delay you're having, sometimes it's not delay. It's meant to make you throw in the towel and give up. But as you open up your mouth, we're about to hit midnight here in Los Angeles. Midnight is an hour where things happen a lot. Around the time, it's morning, you began morning in your country, or is it afternoon? I don't know. But there's no time in the spiritual realm. Time is not a reality. So open up your mouth and say, Lord Jesus. Talk to me, talk to me, talk to me. Say, Lord Jesus, unmute your button. Unmute your Zoom. Open your mouth if you have a mouth. If your mouth is strong enough, open it now. Say, Lord Jesus.
Lord Jesus.
Every evil coffin. Consuming my finances. Consuming my purpose. I come out of this evil coffin. In the name of Jesus Christ. Open up your mouth and pray. I break free from this evil coven. Whatever my head has been laid on an evil altar, let this altar catch fire tonight. In Jesus Christ's name, every untimely death that has targeted my destiny, that has targeted my family, that has targeted my children. Through the blood of Jesus, I reverse back to sender every evil arrow in Jesus' mighty name. Begin to pray. If you can pray in the spirit, if you can clap, however you are led to pray. If you can pray, talk to God. By fire I am set free. By fire I am delivered. Zikata kala brekata sapra. Every buried talent, every buried destiny in my life, let this destiny resurrect in Jesus' mighty name. Talk to God. Every buried talent, every buried destiny, every buried gift. Some of you, you have gifts that are buried. You're so gifted, yet your gift is not functioning. You're using your sweat, your strength. Your gift has become impotent. May your gift be potent today. In Jesus' mighty name, talk to the Lord. Tell the Lord, resurrect my gifts. Talk to him right now. The gifts you put in me, the vessels, the treasures you put in me. Talk to God this hour. I want you to open up your mouth. Say, Lord, I'm set free. I am delivered tonight. In Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' name, every untimely death is terminated on day six.
Untimely death
over my business.
Death over my purpose.
Death over my calling. Some of you, your calling is dead. There are things you got engaged in and your calling is no more. Doesn't even stand anymore. You have no direction because your calling has been tampered with. The Lord has set you free. In Jesus' name. Now, I'm seeing someone being troubled with an evil spirit. Everywhere you walk, you get accused. It's a spirit of accusation. Accusation is a real spirit. Joseph faced the spirit of accusation. Daniel faced the spirit of accusation in the Bible. David faced the spirit of accusation. Saul wanted his life. Saul was twisting everybody, his children. He had conspired to take out the life of David. Accusation is real. Accusation can go anywhere. And it's something that can follow you all your life. You are in school, from elementary school, primary, name it all. You've grown to high school, to college. Every time you're the suspect, there are people right now as I'm talking, because of that spirit. Listen to this. It has caused them to lose favor over time. They hit their mid-20s. There is something going on. The police is looking for someone. They said, oh, you match the description. Tell me right now. Do you know there are people who faced death row? Like death, killed for nothing. After they died, they found out the documents that it wasn't truly them. How can you explain that? It's easy to say it's a mistake. But I'm here to tell you, there is no mistake in the spirit. When accusation comes in your life, it's witchcraft that has switched you from having favor. You are in your workplace, instead of being promoted, you are demoted. You are accused of stealing. You are accused of delaying the company. Yet the one who's delaying the company is right there beside you, lazy. Yet they end up being favored, you end up being put down. Some of you are festers. They don't even work, they sleep. But you work so hard, but everything you do, no one is seeing. All they see is this one is the problem. It's the spirit of accusation. Whether you believe me or not, right now in LA County prison, there are people who are ready to go. They're gone. Their life is terminated. They wanted like, okay, what have I done to deserve this? They are scratching their head, thinking of the last meal they will eat before they die. Yet they're not the one who pulled the trigger. Just because they were in that spot at that time, they got captured and put in. May you be in the right location, not in the wrong location. Some of you also are working with the wrong company. You can work with somebody who has the spirit of accusation. And for the rest of your life, you will suffer accusation because you are around that person. Let the Lord deliver you tonight. In Jesus' name. This spirit has caused you to lack favor everywhere you go. Even if you get a job, you end up crying. You make money, you don't see the money. And even if you make the money, you make it with frustration. Why? You are frustrated at your workplace. You are always being blamed. It's you. I knew it is you. That's the spirit. If you don't deal with it, and you're a single woman, you're a single man, even if you get married, let me tell you the truth. That ain't going nowhere. Your marriage will collapse. Your friendship, fortified friendship with God. You know, the godly people who go, they'll walk away from you. They'll decide to zoom out from your life. Today, open up your mouth. This is day 6. I want you to pray. Say, Lord Jesus.
Lord Jesus, Lord
this
Jesus,
hour, this moment,
this hour, this moment,
as it's day 6,
as it's day 6,
let every spirit of accusation, from my mother's house,
from
my father's house, every curse, that was placed, before I was born. That opened the demon of condemnation.
That opened the demon of condemnation.
An accusation.
Let it
breathe.
Let it break.
Let it break.
I bind this spirit.
In the name of Jesus.
I cast it out.
Out of my life.
Out of my life.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Oh
God, set me free.
Oh God,
arise and fight my battle tonight.
As
I pray in day 6,
turn
everything around.
Set
me free, dear Lord.
Set
me free, sweet Jesus. so that I may not suffer demonic affliction. Every plan of the enemy to accuse me in the future, let this plan break. Let this spirit break. Tonight. I'm set free. Let it break. In Jesus' name. Tonight. I'm set free. Spirit of accusation, out of my life, out of my atmosphere, my workplace. Favor is coming to me in Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' mighty name. I'm set free on day 6 through the blood of Jesus. I am set free. Amen. The other thing is people promise you and they bail out on you. They tell you, hey, I got you. I will do this to you. And I'll give you this. Some of you here watching me, you've been promised a lot of money. Yeah. Someone comes from nowhere, they promise you money, they promise you things. Things they will do for you. And now, after they promise, the time comes, they want to reject. And they want to act like they don't know what you're talking about. They flip on you. This has happened not only on one person in your life, multiple. It's like a promise that's broken. That's a sign that in your bloodline, either in your father's side of the family or mother's side of the family, somebody pledged, and as they pledged, they did not fulfill their pledge that they had pledged to do for someone. And this person spoke, because that pledge was supposed to be a big blessing to that person. It might be in your bloodline. Because the Bible says, what you sow is what you reap. So some of these things is things our ancestors in our bloodline have done before we were born, which we call generational curses. They pledge and then they run away from the pledge. So now, if you do that, or you're that kind of woman, you pledge, or you're that kind of man, your children will receive the repercussion. You tell someone, I'll do this for you. The time comes, you act like, stop disturbing me. Listen, that you're sowing seeds. And some of you, I'm not saying all of you, this has been the case. Let me say something here. Let me say most of you here tonight. Because I'm being led by the Spirit as I pray. Prayer needs revelation. If anybody tells you, hey, jump into prayer and pray without revelation of what you're praying for, you're not going to understand what you're dealing with. You will not know where you're going. Doors cannot open. That's why I'm doing what we call prophetic prayers. I'm doing prophetic. See, there's a difference of just praying and prophetic prayers. Prophetic prayers open up your eyes to like, whoa, this is happening in my life as a pattern. Mm-hmm. Over and over. Now I get it. So this is a generational problem, a bloodline. They pledge, they bail out. Some of you, people have pledged a lot that if people will have fulfilled the pledges they made in your life, some of you will be millionaires by now.
Amen.
But how comes the pledges did not manifest? Now listen, the Bible says those who know their God, they shall do exploits. Those who know their God. Now, if you know from the word knowledge, you know, it must be revelation there. When you pray, pray with revelation. Never pray without revelation. Praying without revelation is like a boxer. A fighter was entered in a ring and they're hitting, they're throwing blows in the air. You will miss. But when you pray with revelation, you know where to hit. Praise God. So this is a 90 day of prayer and fasting. So let us pray. Say, Lord Jesus.
Lord Jesus.
Lord Jesus.
Lord Jesus.
Set me free today.
Set me free today.
Every pledge.
Every pledge.
That men and women have made.
That men and women have made.
Over my life.
Over my life.
And they have not fulfilled.
And they have not fulfilled.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
From my father's house.
My father's house.
My mother's house.
My bloodline.
My father's house. My mother's house. My bloodline. I break free. Pray after me. My mother's house. My father's house. My bloodline. every cast, every altar that was established before I was born, of breaking covenants, of making pledges and not fulfilling, I declare and decree. I revoke this evil spirit that has authority, that has legal ground over my life. From today, I declare and decree every pledge that shall be made over my life, it shall be fulfilled. In Jesus' mighty name.
In Jesus' mighty name.
In Jesus' mighty name. Begin to pray. In Jesus' mighty name. Nakala hila. Izule boshika telebreha. Mantala braga du se prekatole baha. Mikatule breka. Open up your mouth, please. If you have legs, wake up and pray. If you can stand with your phone, where you are, be aggressive. You know, prayer is war. I don't know what position you are. If it's on your knees, I don't know how you're feeling, but this is not a game. Let every pledge be fulfilled in your life from today. I speak and I prophesy over your life as a prophet. Let every pledge that has been spoken over your life be fulfilled tonight. In Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' mighty name. I'm set free tonight, God. Amen. Praise God. Now, the other prayer I want to talk about is, instead of having destiny helpers, you have destiny oppressors. Have you heard of that? Maybe you've not heard of that before. Destiny oppressors. Instead of destiny helpers. There are people in the Bible who faced it. The brothers of Joseph were destiny oppressors. The Saul was a destiny oppressor to David. The three wise men around the council of King Nebuchadnezzar, they were the oppressors of Daniel. Daniel, they wanted to terminate him. They were the oppressors there. Before God takes you to another dimension, there are people who come in the name of God, in the name of a man of God or a woman of God, to become what we call destiny oppressors. And sometimes it's so hidden. Hidden. You won't even see it coming unless your eyes are open in the realms of the spirit. Unless your ears can hear what God is saying. So there's destiny oppressors and destiny helpers. Some of you, all you're fighting with all your life is when you are about to enter into a breakthrough. It's almost, I call it an almost spirit. You're about to enter in your breakthrough like this. Suddenly, depths come from nowhere. Everything begins to collapse. And suddenly, the money you've gotten is used to pay your debts. It's a spirit. It must mean there is someone in your life and there is someone in your circle who is not a destiny helper. They come with the spirit of a destiny oppressor. They don't even need to touch you or do anything. By the virtue of them speaking, things begin to change in your life. They don't even need to know your secrets. Do you know there are people who don't need to know your secret? Yeah. Once they know your secrets, nothing will work. Uh-huh. Even in the family. It could be your own grandma. Once she knows what's going to happen in your life, you're like, what's going on? Nothing happens. She just laughs. She just needs to laugh. Is it? It could be your own uncle. Sometimes it's the closest people to you. It's the closest people to you. Destiny oppressors. Destiny oppressors. They don't need to come physically and oppress you. They just need to speak in your life. Some of you have allowed wrong people to speak into your life. You come with a business idea. Instead of them cheering and clapping and saying this is going to work, they're like, are you sure it's going to really, really work? I don't think it's going to work. It's really hard. All they speak is hardship. They prophesy hardship over your life. But the moment you realize, you're like, I don't even know what made me tell this lady. Because everything they said, or what this man said about how it's going to be hard, it ends up being hard. and you leave that was the thing that was to bring breakthrough in your life, but you leave it. We call it negative speech. We call them negative, but I can say clearly, these are destiny oppressors. Your own biological father could be the one who's raised to be the biggest destiny oppressors. When I talked to the lady yesterday, and I said, why am I seeing your father now on the phone, like destroying people's lives, women and everything? She said, my father called me and said, I'm shocked you're not a prostitute because it runs in our blood. And the father began to laugh. Say, I'm shocked you're not prostituting the way you're supposed to. Because it's in our blood. That's biological father. The lady, the first lady I called yesterday. Destiny oppressors are not far. We think it's someone who has beef with you. No. An enemy you know is not dangerous than an enemy you don't know. Some of you don't even know who your enemy is. If only you knew who your enemy is, you'll be shocked. Now I understand why the network was doing this. I get it. Because this word was traveling from heaven. Traveling was on the way for you to be set free. The Bible says you shall know the truth, and the truth shall what? Set you free. It is the revelation of the truth that sets you free. It doesn't say you shall pray, you shall... No. It shall say you shall know. Before you pray, you have to know. What's the problem? If you don't know, how can you pray what you don't know? Everybody who ever had an encounter with Jesus, they ended up praying. Their life was converted because they knew. They entered into the knowledge of, wow, I'm encountering God. This hour, this moment, whatever continent, whatever country you're watching me from, distance is not a barrier. Open up your mouth and pray like you mean it. Even if you can walk around and pace around in these 90 days, if you're serious, we are going to break through. We are crossing over the Red Sea. We are going to cross over. Let's cross over. Open up your mouth and pray. Say, Lord Jesus.
Lord Jesus.
Every destiny oppressor.
Every destiny oppressor.
Pretending to be a friend.
Pretending to be a friend.
Prophesying doom over my life.
Prophesying doom over my life.
I declare and decree I am set free.
I declare and decree I am set free.
I am delivered in Jesus Christ's name.
I am delivered in Jesus Christ's name.
Oh God, release every destiny help us tonight.
Oh God, release every destiny help us.
Whatever
tonight.
They are, God, let them locate me tonight.
Wherever they are, God, let them locate me
in
tonight.
In Jesus' mighty name, bring more destiny help us, Lord.
Bring more destiny help us, God.
Decrease the influence of destiny destroyers.
Decrease the influence of destiny destroyers.
Let them not have authority over my head.
Let them not have authority over my head.
Every evil thing prophesied over my destiny and my life.
Every evil thing prophesied over my
life. I command it to break, and I break free now in Jesus' mighty name.
I command it to break, and I break free.
The words they have used as an arrow to terminate me and target me.
The words they've used to target me.
Arrows of sickness.
Arrows of sickness.
Arrows of failure.
Arrows of failure.
I command these arrows by fire to break.
I command these arrows
in Jesus'
break.
Mighty name.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
I declare and decree, Lord, my eyes are open in the spirit.
My eyes are
my ears are open in the spirit.
By the
blood of Jesus Christ.
By the blood of Jesus Christ.
This is my time. This is my season.
My time, this is
through
my
the
season.
Blood of Jesus, I'm set free.
Jesus, I'm set free.
Every evil yoke is broken.
Every evil yoke is broken.
In Jesus' mighty name.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Oh Lord Jesus, let every destiny oppressor be exposed in my life tonight. Let them not ring my phone.
Let them not ring my phone.
Let them not be connected to me.
Let them not be connected to me, Jesus.
Let whatsoever they've spoken lose influence.
Whatsoever they've spoken over my life.
Let whatsoever has been said backfire.
Whatsoever has been said backfire.
In my family.
In my family.
My company.
My company.
My friends.
My friends.
My co-workers.
My co-workers.
Any destiny oppressor.
Any destiny oppressor.
Who's hidden.
Who's hidden.
Let them be exposed
by
fire.
Let them be exposed by fire.
By the fire of God.
By the fire of
God. I am set free.
I am set free.
I am delivered tonight.
I am delivered tonight.
I am set free.
I am set free.
I am delivered tonight.
I am delivered tonight.
In Jesus' mighty name.
In Jesus' mighty name.
I declare and decree.
I declare and decree.
My name shall rise.
My
star shall shine.
Because destiny help us.
Hear my sound.
Hear my voice.
I prophesy in the atmosphere. I prophesy in Jesus' name. They are coming my way.
They
are already around my life.
They are around my life.
They will manifest in my life. In Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' mighty name.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
Now,
clap
for Jesus.
Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit.
Thank you, Jesus.
Now, another thing I want to deal with is the spirit of shame.
Yes, Lord.
Every time from when you were young, you were embarrassed. You are always embarrassed. It began with your own father. Your father is going in public. He's mishandled. So bad by the police. He's mishandled by the government. He's mishandled by his co-workers. His boss mishandles him, speaks to him so bad. Get out of here.
Yeah.
They chase him. Get out. Go. They chase your father like a dog. Your biological father. Your mother is always embarrassed. In the middle of the road, she stands like this. She falls down or something happens. Her clothes falls off. Everybody sees her nakedness. That's shame. There's a spirit of shame. And some of you don't know shame can follow you. It can follow you and can cause limitation in your life. If your father was dishonored everywhere he went, you are a kid, you're watching. Some of you, you know. Your mother was always misrepresented, dishonored. Instead of people talking to her like, hey, mom, how are you? Say, hey, lady, get out of here. Ah, get out, they chase her. Your mother runs. She doesn't even walk. They make her run. You are born in this household. There's a problem. And this is what causes anxiety. You see someone saying, I can't do this thing of Christianity anymore. Because you have no revelation of the real problem. Yeah. You see how your brothers and sisters are dishonored in public. They don't even call your father by his name. Sometimes they do. Psst, psst, psst. Hey, hey. Psst, psst, psst. As if he's a dog. So now you think, oh, he's just old. You grew up seeing this. The question I have for you, how comes people are doing the same things to you? It's a spirit of shame. When we talk about prayer and deliverance, before God blesses you, there are strongholds sometimes that are hidden in our life. That if these strongholds don't move off the way, even if God blesses you, you are so blessed, you're always dishonored. It's very difficult for you to be honored. The last time you're honored is only people who God has given revelation of who you are. But rather than that, everybody around you dishonor. Someone will say, well, Jesus suffered and everything. No. Before he suffered and went through what he went through, he had favor with men. He was honored. He also had honor from the disciples. They honored him. When he called Matthew, he said, follow me. He listened to him. He followed. When he went to Peter, Peter followed. He went to Andrew. Andrew followed. That's honor. When he told Peter, take back the boat, let's go fish. That's honor. Jesus came for an assignment. He became an atonement of sin to die. He became a curse so that you may be blessed. He took, he bore all your iniquities just for you. He exchanged his life for you. So in his ministry, before he began, there was honor. When he entered in Jerusalem, they took palm trees and put him down. Honor. He was on a donkey. There are people who preach that Jesus was just slapped and spit on. Listen, that's just a side of his life before he died. That's when now he was going to die. The time had come. for him to fulfill what was written in Isaiah. So the ministry of Jesus had honor. So dishonor is a real spirit. Now, dishonor and shame. We are dealing with shame and dishonor. Some of you began in elementary school. You stood in front of everybody, you're peeing on yourself like this. You think you're peeing on yourself and you're peeing on yourself and it's just funny. And now you feel very strange. The moment that happened, or you stood in front of everybody and you pooped on yourself in public or in school as a kid, the moment you felt that shame and it came so strong, that's when the spirit was invited and it entered and it dwelt. Some of you have gone through this. Some of you have gone through this. Some of you have walked in public, your dress, you're a woman. It was tall. Everything was exposed. Your nakedness was shown. Some of you are men. Your own mother opened the door. You are a grown man. They saw you naked. You're taking a shower. That's shame. You're a parent. Your own children, they always walk on you naked. Ah! Yeah, I am a father. But never in these 8 years, my child has ever walked on me naked. My child is hitting 8. Never. Some of you, this has happened. And you're like, oh, sorry, sorry, baby. Huh? You think it's normal? That is a spirit there. Of you seeing your own mother multiple times, your grandmother, you see them naked every time. Some family members live like that. You see them naked. Eh? Your uncle is naked. You see him scratching himself like this. Naked. You think it's normal? Shame. That's dishonor. Remember, there was Shem, Ham, and Japheth. Ham, when Noah was drunk, instead of Ham covering his father, he went and called his two brothers and said, come see Papa. Papa is naked. Do you know that was dishonor? The moment that happened, Ham was cast. He became the servants of servants. All his generation, read the text, he was cursed. It is also a curse. When shame and dishonor is there, that is the sign of the presence for you tonight. Let the Lord deliver you tonight. Share the live broadcast to our prophetic people on social media, Facebook Live, and Zoom. If you could go later on after we are done, you share the live broadcast, someone will be delivered. The curse of Ham, Noah's son, because the two other brothers covered their father. Because shame is so sacred. You know, they didn't play back in them days. They knew how it's so sacred for your nakedness not to be exposed. Open up your mouth and pray. Say, Lord Jesus.
Lord Jesus.
Tonight. Today.
Today.
This hour, this moment. I declare and decree.
God,
set me free.
Oh God, set me free.
Every spirit of dishonor. Spirit of embarrassment.
Spirit of shame.
Break out of my life. Now, when the spirit of shame is there, the anointing of authority is taken away from you. Do you know that? You are never bold. You can never walk in the authority of God when you're always ashamed. When they embarrass you, it's very difficult. That spirit comes there to take the authority of God in your life. God wants to put his authority, his anointing of authority. When you speak, when you do something, people listen. When you do certain things, people honor you. That spirit there, it robs the authority. You become just like a fly walking around. You become what we call a busybody. Open up your mouth and pray with me. Say, Lord Jesus.
Lord Jesus.
Tonight.
Day six.
I'm set free.
I break free.
Through the blood of Jesus.
From the spirit of dishonor.
The spirit of shame. From my father's house.
My bloodline.
In Jesus' name. Every blanket of dishonor that has removed the spirit of God, that has tampered with the anointing, that has caused me to lose authority, that has caused me to lose boldness. I command this spirit to break out of my life this hour, this moment, as I open up my mouth, I command it to break out of my life. out of my destiny in Jesus' mighty name. Open up your mouth and pray tonight in Jesus' mighty name. Zifrika tolebreha, lukutishikata, zumparabasutetopra. Open up your mouth, say, Lord, by fire, let this spirit be consumed. Come on, open up your mouth where you're seeing me. Don't sleep on me, don't sleep on me now. Open up your mouth if you have lungs. Open up your mouth, declare in the atmosphere, declare in the air. Prophesy over your head, every spirit of shame, garments of shame, catch fire, garments of dishonor over my life, catch fire in Jesus Christ's name. Garments of shame, garments of dishonor, catch fire through my bloodline in Jesus' mighty name. Over my face, my face, let my face have honor. My countenance will radiate the honor of God. The honor from God in Jesus' mighty name. Lord, set me free. Increase favor. Increase wisdom over my life. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you, Holy Spirit.
You know what I'm about to talk about now?
Thank you, Jesus.
Something very interesting. I'm about to share days. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. Some of you, you might not know this, but those days are names of Greek gods. In the Greek mythology, sun was the day of the Sunday. Moon was the day of the moon. But I don't want to go into all that, because I'm not teaching Greek mythology. What I'm teaching tonight is, those days were named after Greek deities. So there are days that are speaking against you. Joshua spoke to the moon and the sun in the valley of Ajalon. The moon stayed in the valley of Ajalon. The sun stood still. The moon and the sun represents day and night. So for you to have the next day, you need to have the day and night, then the next day, night, then the next day and night. So he spoke to that day. We don't know what day it was, but he spoke to the sun to stand still till they win the war. And the moon to stand still in the valley of Ajalon. Some of you, the day Monday, which is Moon Day. You gotta know these days what they were named after. Greek gods, Greek deities. Some of you, Friday doesn't like you. Every time Friday hits, you're sick. Some of you, Mondays, when Monday hits like this, it's like you're angry. The Moon Day. Something about the moon. When Monday hits, you become angry. You start becoming like, it's like you're frustrated. Monday. Anytime you do a business deal or meeting on Monday, things backfire. And that's why some of you say, I don't like Tuesdays. I don't know if I'm right. Some of you have days you don't like for no reason. Ever since you were born, you don't know why you don't like that day. Most of you might be Monday. Monday is when the full moon, the worship of the moon. Most of you don't like Monday. And you say, I like Friday, but you don't know what Friday represents. Or some of you, Sundays. Sundays, everything don't go right. You feel like you just want to sleep. It's like you want to do nothing. That's when you become very weak. You're drained. When it hits Sunday, it's like, the Sunday. Your whole body, it's like you enter in a slow motion mood, like this. You become sluggish, as if somebody hit you. You've already had the weekend, Saturday. But it hits Sunday, you're like this. You're drowsy. You look like you're drunk, and you're not drunk. It means there's a problem with that day. That day is speaking over your life. These things I'm speaking is mystery. It takes someone who's discerning and prayerful to understand. Some of you are going through this now. If you are here, you're going through this. I want to hear you. And I want to open your Zoom. I want to hear your testament, your testimony of a specific day that frustrates you. Because I might be... You might wonder, like, some of you might understand, some of you might not. But is there someone specific here? If a certain day hits like this, your knees begin to hurt. That day is speaking over you. Yeah. Joshua had power over the time. He had power over time. He said, he had to freeze time. Because he knew that day, if the sun didn't stand still, they would have lost the battle. So I want to ask someone here today, what day? Tell me this day that needs to stand still for you to win. Is there a specific day? Because I want us to pray. If you're here online, unmute your button on Zoom. I want to hear someone telling me yes, a specific day. Maybe 2 days as a testament. Is there somebody? I see Kelvin here. I see Samuel. Pastor Samuel, I see. Yes. Yes. Someone needs to talk to me. Is there a specific day? I see Steve. I see Zola. I see Nicole. I see Bangs. I see Mary. Give me a day. There's something going on. Someone is saying, Ivania says true. Someone give me a day. Maybe someone died in your family, your mother or father. And ever since that day, things don't go well. When it hits that day, always something bad happens. Or a specific month, when it hits like this, you're even afraid for the month to come, but you don't even know why. Talk to me. Okay, who's this talking? It's
Sheila.
Okay, hold on. Put Sheila a little bit. Sheila, tell me something. This is
for
interesting.
Me, it's the month of May.
Oh, this is Sheila.
Oh, okay.
Hello? Yeah, I can hear you.
For me, it's the month of May.
So hold on a little bit.
Hello, can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you. You're saying something?
I'm saying for me it's the month of May. I lost my dad and uncle on the same day. In the month of May. And then just this past Monday, I lost my dad's sister. He just died this week.
You heard what I said? Jesus. I said it might be someone who died at a specific day. And every time that day, why are they all dying in May? There is something about me that you yourself need to be careful of me. Father, your father, his brother, and your aunt, siblings dying in me. Imagine.
Jesus.
It looks like as if it's scripted. Because in the spirit world, it's already targeted. That me, even you yourself on me, things don't go well. Even this May, you are having frustration a lot.
Yeah.
Beyond even the death of the auntie. Whenever it hits May, let God deliver you, Sheila.
In the name of Jesus.
Sheila,
amen.
Let the Lord Jesus deliver you now. Let this May from today turn into a blessing. You know, there are times I prophesied to people, I said, your month is October. The Lord showed me in October there is a blessing coming in October. I prophesied to a couple of people before. Sheila, may this month be of deliverance to your life in Jesus' mighty name. From today be delivered from May. May turn into a blessing in Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' mighty name. If you are here, you can jump on the Zoom because very soon my Facebook Live, I'll cut it off. Very soon it's going to cut off my Facebook Live. And that's okay. It is well. I want to talk to you. Let the Lord set you free. Let the Lord set you free. In Jesus' mighty name. Right now, lift up your hands. Kariya bason telebregadosia. Be delivered now. Be set free. May speak life to you, not death. By the blood of Jesus. May speak life to you, not death. May favor follow you, this May. May everything you touch prosper in the name of Jesus. May any affliction that has caused you pain lose influence today. In Jesus' mighty name. Today is your hour of deliverance. The Lord has set you free. I rebuke Satan in the name of Jesus. Through the blood of Jesus.
Amen.
This is the day that the Lord has made. Your season has come. Let every fruit you planted be manifested this season. Before this month is over.
Amen.
Let God do a turnaround. A turnaround has already taken place, Sheila. Completely done.
Amen.
Completely done. In Jesus' mighty name. The curse is revoked.
Amen.
I declare the prophet over your life.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. It is done.
Amen.
Talabakatishia. Ivania Vincent says, I can't get on. This is Ivania. And I see Anthony Mwangi. And I see a couple of people. Ivania is saying, every Monday I always feel frustrated. Well, I can say from Monday through Thursday. See, from Monday through Thursday. She's saying from Monday through Thursday. You say you cannot get on. Try get off, Ivania, and then try and get on. Let God deliver you tonight. In Jesus' mighty name, it is done. Anybody else has a testament, a testimony of a specific day? Whenever this day hits, like it hits you so hard, it might be a Thursday. You don't even know why Thursday. You might think, well, it's just my mind. Maybe it's my mind just messing tricks with me. I don't like Thursdays. If you don't like that day ain't gonna like you. That day will not like you. Assured and assurance. We break every demonic insurance tonight. So I want to talk to somebody. I want to talk to somebody right now. Please talk to me. Something is not adding up. So speak to me. Talk to me.
I often have a hard time with Saturday.
Ah, you often have a hard time with Saturday.
Yeah, I would dread Saturday.
Why specifically Saturday? Saturday is supposed to be a day we enjoy, we have fun, we dance, we... I'm not going to say necessarily dance, but just we chill.
Yeah, I had a hard time with chilling, relaxing, or resting.
How long has this been?
Probably 4 years. I just know that I remember we said certain days. The Saturdays are days that I did not like to see coming.
Saturdays is the days you didn't like to see coming.
Mm-hmm.
It simply means there's something with Saturday. There's something with Saturday that's not right. There's warfare on that day. So it means when the sun begins to shine on Saturday, danger, accidents, stress, fighting. There are things that come, even in your past relationship, marriage, Saturdays, fights. I see like in a club, fighting in the past, like someone almost got killed.
I wouldn't know about someone getting killed, but I know that Saturdays was a day like, in my marriage we'll be together, but it wasn't a good day.
Even for your marriage?
Yeah, it wasn't a good day. It was like I was excited for us to probably be able to spend time together, but we never would.
Wow. So Saturday hits, let the Lord deliver you now.
Yeah, yeah.
Let the Lord deliver you now.
In the mighty name of Jesus, I see.
Father, I declare and decree total deliverance now, this hour, this moment. Let Saturday be a day that serves you. May Saturday be your servant. You can't be the servant of Saturday. Now, people of God, I want to share something. As I'm speaking to you right now, I want to share something with you as I share with everybody. Do you know that God created everything around us to be under us, because we are created in the likeness of God, for us to rule over every creation around, even the days and everything. The days were created, everything was created for us to have full dominion over these days. Joshua exercised it. The sun and the moon, the sun stood still, the moon stood still in the valley of Ajalon, meaning Joshua had power, power to control his day to our victory. If the day wasn't controlled by what he declared, if he didn't speak to that day, he wouldn't have power over that day. Sometimes we don't have power over a certain year, a certain month, because we haven't spoken prophetically over that year, over that month. And that's why that month becomes catastrophic. You wonder, like, what's going on? Like, hell breaks loose. Because you got to understand, every day, the sun can hear. The sun can hear. So meaning there are days that when the sun shines, it doesn't shine right on you. And that's why the book of Psalms, it says, the sun shall not smite you, nor the moon shall not at night. The sun nor the moon. Why does he talk about the sun and the moon? That's David talking. Because David had revelation of the sun. There are people who worship the sun as a deity, as a god, in different parts of the world. In different parts of the world. The ancient Mayans. The Mayans who built pyramids. There's more pyramids in Mexico than we could ever even... We think Egypt has pyramids. But the Mayans worship the sun. You know? And the god called Kukulkan and everything. Which is the serpent god. And they believed in the apocalypse. The revelation of the apocalypse. When the apocalypse comes, it signified blood needed to be shed. During the Mayan Empire. So when the sun was blotted, it means they had to shed blood for human sacrifice. So the sun has been there. The sun was created to rule the day. The Bible says in Genesis, it was created as the greater light. And the moon was created as the lesser light. But the sun and the moon represent time. They represent time. So it means something has tampered with your time in the realms of the spirit. Something has tampered with your time. If you're here on Facebook Live, you can jump on Zoom, because I'm about to end my Facebook Live. It's going to end abruptly, you know, because I've set it, all right? Now we are called by God to control time, not for time to control us. And Joshua exercised it as he raised his hands. Now when Moses was losing, when the children of Israel was losing the battle, Aaron had to come and they had to lift up the hands of Moses and his rod. And when his hands were lifted up, they started winning the battle during that day. But once his hands were down, they were losing the battle. So this is what the Lord is saying. You have power to control time. What Joshua did, Joshua exercised what every believer should be exercising in the New Testament. Every day. That's why witches and witch doctors and wizards, they know the mystery of time. There's certain times they go and worship their deities. You know, 12 to 3 o'clock is time of witches at night. In different parts of the world, even in the occult, they have their own time where they do rituals. But we believers have not understood the mystery of time. Once you know the mystery of time, once we know the mystery of time, we'll be able to control what God has given us. You see, when Adam and Eve died, when Adam and Eve died in the Garden of Eden, when they died spiritually, they lost the power over time, because time equals to eternity. Time is eternity. They lost eternity, time. They were created as immortals. They became mortals once they ate the forbidden fruit. Satan was after time. He needed their time. He wanted to control their time. So Christ Jesus comes and dies on the cross as an atonement of sin to give you back, you and I, to give us believers time. To give us time, to restore us with the authority of controlling time, not time to control us. So if there's a specific day that speaks havoc, that speaks frustration, oppression over you, it simply means your destiny. There's something with your destiny. God wants your time to be, for you to have power. That power is restored on Calvary. He wants you to regain the power that Monday will listen to you, Tuesday will listen to you. If Wednesday has to freeze, Wednesday will freeze. If Saturday will have to wait for you, Saturday will wait for you. For the will of God is for us not to be surprised by the future, but for us to surprise the future. And that's why Joshua did something crazy. That was a long day till they won the battle. There are battles you can never win until you have power over time. There are battles you can never win as a believer until you have powers over seasons, times, days. And also, if you read the story of the sons of Issachar, we're in the season of Issachar right now. We're in the season of Issachar in the Hebrew calendar. It is the Issachar season. When you read about Issachar, which was the 12 tribes of Israel, one of them, they knew the times and seasons. They had power. They knew about times and seasons. They were prophetic. So if you're a prophetic woman or man, you have to know the times that we're living in. And that's why we have what we call in eschatology the end times. We're in the end times. There's a lot of things happening during this time. I don't know if I'm talking to you. So you have power over Saturday, I prophesy. Saturday has no power over you. Saturday can't control you. The moment you will wake up on Saturday and you hit the floor like this from your bed, Saturday will freeze on behalf of you. Saturday has no power in Jesus' mighty name. Because when Saturday, the sun is shining, it's the sun on Saturday that is speaking over your life. It is dominating you. That's why Psalms, in the book of Psalms, David said it. The sun will not smite you by day, nor the moon by night. Why did he say that? Because David knew what the sun can do to a man, what the moon can do to a man. Ziba bababo selegadadosha. Share the live broadcast on social media. Maria gadusile brahatuskia. Rikatusia. I want to talk to somebody. Huriabaga. Hey guys, if my social media goes off, there's a Zoom link right there. Copy paste it already. If you haven't copy pasted the Zoom link online live, you can copy paste it on social media live, because this is about to go off right now. My live feed. It's about to go off. My Zoom is on. Praise God. Calabrica, I want to ask questions and teach. I want to ask questions. Is there somebody who has a question on our Zoom meeting tonight? Calaria Bazaga. Copy paste that right there, right? That link on your phone. If you're watching me right now, because I'm about to get it off. Celebrity, is it? How is it? Tomorrow is day 7. And the Bible says, on the 7th day, God rested. What does 7 signify in the realms of the spirit? Why 7? The book of Revelation talks about the 7 spirits of God. The 7 churches. Laodicea, Capernaum, Philadelphia. So God is good. Is it? You want to try? Kara de Ziela. Okay, it's back. All right, my Facebook Live, if you have copy-pasted this, good. I'm on Zoom right now. So I'm getting off social media, Facebook Live. I'm getting off. What is this? Oh my goodness. What's the meaning of this? Facebook Live is the one. What is this? He signed out. Strange. But it is well with the righteous. So, if you're here, God bless you. I want to see. So, can you sign back in? Solabrikatuskia. Tonight is too much fire. Too much fire.
Okay. Let me see something real quick. Sipra katushibia. Kiriabazontelebregaduskia. Kalabushkia. We serve a living God. Let God arise and fight your battle. This is the hour that the Lord has made. Declare and be glad in it. Thank you, Lord. Solo abubo shite de basa. Tipa kato shkete la. My goodness, I want to see something. Wanna send the links. You've created a new one. Shiria Katuski, ha. Kaladiesh Kataladuski. Let's pray. So if you are, if join me on the Zoom live, let God do something here tonight on Facebook live. So like as I was teaching earlier on, we're about to repost a new Zoom link, but I rebooted a little bit. I'm trying to see. Karia Basunte. So let the Lord Jesus deliver you. Let your day not be controlled by anything. Let God give you grace. In the mighty name of Jesus, your day shall not be controlled by anything. In Jesus' mighty name, your day shall not be controlled by anything. In Jesus' mighty name, Kalearia Basanta Labrika Tuskia. Let the Lord Jesus arise and fight your battle tonight. From wherever you're watching me, let God do something new in your life. I pray for Latoya Harris, Nichols, Ivania. Lebashiti Bregaduskia, Sentala Bragaduskia, Letishis Katalabrosia. I want questions. Get ready for the. I need a lot of. Tomorrow, I want a lot of questions. Like, pull up questions that are coming to your spirit about days and times and everything. Because I'll delight to answer the questions as I'm led by the Spirit of God. I perceive a great grace. I perceive the anointing increasing. The anointing is increasing so strong. It is well with the righteous. Pala bashikra katuskia. Latoya, my daughter, God bless you. Pauline, you say good morning from Denmark. Ivana, you say yes. Who is this online? Celebre katuskia. Wendy Ramdin, more grace upon you. Pauline, Latoya, Nichols, thank you, Lord. Your grace is sufficient, Lord. You have done something new over your children's lives tonight. In Jesus' mighty name. Kalabatish katalabra. Alabra hatu lebregaduskia. Eze, you say, I'm here. Let God turn around everything in your life. In the mighty name of Jesus, let what was difficult become easy. In Jesus' mighty name, I declare and decree. Latash katalabrosia. Lotush katalabrosia. I see Kelvin, my son, more grace upon you. Today there's a turnaround in your life. Something has been released in your life. In Jesus' name, it is well. It is well. My shepherd shall continue. With the just... Shepre Katuski Hala shall continue another time on the Zoom, but I speak a blessing online here. Lepa Katasiara Katuskia. Dana, God is talking to you a lot. Mary, too much revelation. Kashif, I see Williams, too much revelation. God is talking to you. God is opening your ears in the spirit. Kalarazia katusia. You know, Kelvin, he says, this teaching is powerful. More grace upon you, son. You're too anointed. Joy. Oh, Jesus, remember me today. When do you say, Papa, please pray for me. Attack on my life. You say you want the Lord to do something in your life. May you be delivered, Wendy. May you be delivered from affliction and demonic frustration. You can't concentrate. There's a problem with your concentration. Let the Lord Jesus deliver you tonight, Wendy. Share the live broadcast if you're watching this to 12 prophetic people coming to your spirit. My ears say you're doing something powerful. That's all the attacks. But God is fighting for you. Ah, that's good. I'm humble and I receive that. I receive that politely in Jesus' name. So my Zoom meeting has suddenly ended just abruptly like that. You know, it's something I cannot explain, but it is well. You know, we are doing something good. This is day six. So join us on live. This is day six. Don't be troubled. Join us on this live. God is settling things that no man can settle. In Jesus' mighty name. If God is for you, who can be against you? Nobody. You need to understand that. So open up your mouth and thank God. Thank Him today. Thank Him for this wonderful time. Tell Him, Lord, I love You. You have vindicated me. You have done something new in my life. Talk to God. You have vindicated me. You have done something new in my life, Lord. Thank You for redeeming me. Thank You for opening my eyes in the spirit. Thank You for setting me free from demonic affliction tonight. In Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' mighty name. Thank the Lord for this wonderful night tonight. God has done it. In Jesus' mighty name. God has done it. Affliction is broken. I see joy. Bless you. Pauline, Wendy, you say thank you, Jesus. It is done. Share to 12 prophetic people. Alima Ahmed. May God bless you too much. When you travel, I pray God opens the doors that you're able to travel and visit us. We will receive you. In Jesus' name. With a lot of love. Palabashikri katuskia. As you see, my son, he said, continue with us. The revelation are flowing very well. Someone talk to me. Sekara dazia talabri katuskia. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Sepre katushia prakatusa. Wendy, you say shared. God bless you, Wendy. Your heart is very kind. May God bless you and touch you in ways that no man will take credit, but only God will be glorified in your life. Palabatesh katalabra, sitalabraha tushkitelebraha, nemanto lebregaduskia. Lord, you have done it. Thank you for vindication, Lord. Tonight you have released an anointing of vindication, Lord. Thank you for remembering your children tonight. In Jesus' mighty name. Kola braha toskitele breha. Zentola braha. Zetishkata la braha. Zetea sepreka toskia la braha. May you pray upon my month of May. May be a blessing over you. God bless you. So I'm back live tonight. I'll be back live tomorrow. So I want you to join me on Facebook Live. I'll be on live tomorrow, 10. Let's take this to the next level. I'm just tired of medicine. This is Lilian Acheng Rangoma. Did I say your name right? Lilian Acheng Rangoma. May God set you free. Set you free. Lilian, may God set you free. May God have an appointment with you. In Jesus' mighty name, right now, may you have a visitation with God tonight. In Jesus' mighty name, Shipreka, thank you for Pauline, thank you for grace, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name. Wendy, you say I will join you tomorrow, 10 p.m. Pacific time. Join me tomorrow, 10 p.m. Pacific time. Specifically Pacific time. There's something God is going to do. There's something God is already doing. 10 p.m. Pacific time. It's done. 10 p.m. Pacific time. Thank you, Lord. I see you. Who's online? I want to see the people that are with me. Lillian. Thank you, Lord. Kuala da Shiskia. La tata skatala da 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 da. Papa pa shakaraba setelea. Zetala bakata sha. Sita la braka tushkea. Father, arise and fight the battle for your children, Lord. Increase them, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Shikaraba zuteria bakatuskia. Toka braka tushkia. I see Bawani. You say I'm here. Okay, good. Bawani, I see Grace. You say we are there. I see Pauline. Okay, good. I see Banks, my son. Great. I see Vanya Vincent. And I see Joy. Joy, God bless you, Joy. I see Mary. You say I'm here. I see your people, Lord. OKK, God bless you. Thank you for Wendy's life, Lord. So tomorrow is going to be an amazing time. You don't want to miss. I'm talking about seven. There are seven things I want us to pray for. Tomorrow is the seventh day. So if you want to give, that is our website. From whatever country you're watching us from internationally, be it in Europe, be it here in the United States, that's our website. Go to our website, click the link, and be a blessing to our ministry, and God is going to bless you if you've been blessed tonight. If you want to partner with our ministry, you can also partner with our ministry on a monthly basis. Whatever the Lord puts in your spirit, commit it and God will bless you. Arabaseha, zerera shiprekatuskiha, talabrekatuskiha, lapatushketelebreha, sentalabrakatushketelebreha, shiprekatuskiha. Yes, Lord, matushketelegra, it is done in Jesus' name. So, Father, Lord, as I conclude this prayer tonight, I close in prayer prophetically, Lord. Touch your children, Lord. Increase them. Increase them. Let them see redemption. If you are here, you would like to rededicate your life to Jesus, I want you to pray after me. Say, Dear Heavenly Father, I come before you as a sinner today. I believe you died on the cross for my sins. Lord Jesus, I accept you as my Savior today. Amen. If you pray that prayer, you're born again. In Jesus' name, it is well. Joy, from today, may you sleep. May God give you divine sleep that no human can take credit of. No medicine. You're delivered. Amen. So once again, if you want to be a blessing, you can go to our website. That's our website right there. It's judahangelos.com. You can go to judahangelos.com, click it, and be a blessing. And God will bless you. See you tomorrow at 10 p.m. Pacific time. May you never lack in the mighty name of Jesus. Shalom. May Elkanu and Sidkenu bless you. I'm out. Bless you all. Shalom.